Now we will see about the vitamin B6. Vitamin B6 is also called as pyridoxine, as these are derivatives of pyridine, so we call it as a pyridoxine. And there are three types of molecules are present. Three components are present in vitamin B6. One is pyridoxine. Second is pyridoxamine. And third is pyridoxal. So there are three types are there. As the name suggests, this is an aldehyde, this is amine, and this is a normal compound, now the alcoholic group. So these three combined together will be forming vitamin B6. This vitamin B6 is a water soluble B complex vitamin. Water-soluble B-complex vitamin, which is having collectively these three forms, pyridoxine, pyridoxamine, and pyridoxal. It is a derivative of pyridine and has a structure for this three molecules are very much similar. They are, as said, derivatives of pyridine, where we have CH2OH at fifth position, methyl group at second position, again an OH at third position, and a CH2OH at fourth position. This is pyridoxine. Pyridoxal will have an aldehydic derivative, that is at fourth position, instead of CH2OH, it will be having a CHO. So this is pyridoxal, and in pyridoxamine we will have CH2NH2 at fourth position. These are the three molecules, three components for vitamin B. Each one of them constitutes vitamin B6. Any one of them can be acting in a particular reaction. So it is not necessary ki sare ke sare ek saath hone chahiye, aisa zaruri nahi hai. Koi bhi ek hoga inme se to bhi chalta hai, wahan pe reaction complete hota hai. These three molecules differs at the fourth position. Fourth position mein yahan pe difference hota hai. One is having a CH2OH, then we have a CHO, and last we have a CH2NH2. All other things remains same. The pyridine ring is the main nucleus for this vitamin B6. And amongst these three, pyridoxine is present mainly in plants, while pyridoxal and pyridoxamine are present in animals. This is not thermostable, while pyridoxine is thermostable. This has a great consequences. Also, this pyridoxine can be converted to pyridoxal, and pyridoxine can be converted to pyridoxamine, but the reverse is not true. That is, this process doesn't occur. That is, pyridoxal to pyridoxine doesn't occur. Similarly, pyridoxamine to pyridoxal also does not occur. पिरिडॉक्सिन से हम पिरिडॉक्सल या पिरिडॉक्सामाइन्स बना सकते हैं, लेकिन पिरिडॉक्सामाइन से पिरिडॉक्सिन नहीं बनता है, या पिरिडोक्साल से भी पिरिडोक्सिन नहीं बनता है, लेकिन पिरिडोक्साल से पिरिडोक्सामाइन बनता है और पिरिडोक्सामाइन से पिरिडोक्साल भी बनता है। सो दिस प्रोसेस इज ऑलवेज अवेलेबल, लेकिन यहां से यहां पे नहीं जा सकते हैं, लेकिन इसका उल्टा चलता है, दैट इज पिरिडोक्सिन से पिरिडोक्साल एज वेल एज पिरिडोक्सामाइन आर सिंथेसाइजेबल। ऑल्सो पिरिडोक्सामाइन पिरिडोक्सिन कैन इज ए stable, thermostable, or it is more thermostable. Pyridoxal and pyridoxamine are less thermostable. Less thermostable means around 40-50 degree Celsius तक उनको कुछ नहीं होता है, लेकिन उससे ज्यादा अगर हीट करते हो तो pyridoxal और pyridoxamine दोनों ही रप्चर हो जाते हैं, उनका स्ट्रक्चर टूट जाता है। सो दिस हैज ग्रेटर कॉन्सिक्वेंसेज कि प्लांट सोर्सेस जो हम खाना खाते हैं प्लांट सोर्सेस से, उसको जब हम कुक करते हैं तो कुक करने पर पिरिडोक्सिन जो है वो हमारा रह जाता है। पिरिडोक्सिन में कुछ प्रॉब्लम नहीं आता है, पिरिडोक्सिन ऐसे ही रह जाता है, लेकिन अगर हम एनिमल सोर्सेस के फूड को कुक करते हैं लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल मीट एग फिश, तो इनको अगर हम कुक करते हैं तो इसमें से जो पिरिडोक्साल और पिरिडोक्सामाइन रहते हैं वो सारे वैनिश हो जाते हैं, their structure gets ruptured or their structure breaks down and so therefore they are no longer a source of our vitamins. So वहां से हमको vitamin नहीं मिल सकता है because on cooking they will get loosened up or they will lose the vitamin B6. So animal sources cooked food are not a good sources of vitamin B6. Animal sources are not a good sources of vitamin B6 if they are cooked. Raw material ऐसे ही raw अगर दिया तो चलता है, and raw हम generally human beings नहीं consume करते हैं, other animals consume it raw meats, and so carnivore जो animals होते हैं उनके लिए animal sources are the only sources for vitamin B6. So now sources for this are sources for vitamin B6. This is widely distributed in food chain. So there are lots of sources for vitamin B6 are present. The good sources amongst this includes whole grains. Then we have vegetables, particularly corn, cabbage, soya bean. These are good sources of vitamin B6. Similarly, bananas are also very good sources of vitamin B6. Then we have nuts, fish, eggs. These are also very good sources of vitamin B6. Milk is also having certain quantities of vitamin B6, but not a very good source of vitamin B6. लेकिन इसमें से भी हमें विटामिन B6 कुछ मात्रा में मिलता है। सो दीज आर सोर्सेस फॉर विटामिन B6। बायोकेमिकल फंक्शंस ऑफ विटामिन B6। Vitamin B6 is generally used for transamination reaction and decarboxylation reactions of amino acids. हमने decarboxylation reactions देखे थे vitamin B1 के, vitamin B1 also catalyzes decarboxylation reaction, but for carbohydrates. Proteins का decarboxylation या amino acid का decarboxylation विटामिन B6 करता है, एंड कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स का डीकार्बोक्सिलेशन विटामिन B1 करता है। कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स में कार्बोक्सिलेट ग्रुप नहीं होता है, लेकिन अपॉन ऑक्सीडेशन वी गेट कार्बोक्सिलेट ग्रुप्स, लाइक फ्रॉम ग्लूकोज वी गेट पाइरुविक एसिड एंड ऑक्सलो एसिटिक एसिड और सिट्रिक एसिड वी गेट इट. सो दोज आर अंडरगोइंग डी कार्बोक्सिलेशन यूजिंग विटामिन बी. यहाँ पे बायोकेमिकल फंक्शंस ऑफ विटामिन बी सिक्स कंसिस्ट, द फर्स्ट वन एज इट हेल्प्स इन एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ फैट्स एंड प्रोटीन्स. वेन एवर वी ईट आवर फूड इफ इट इज कंटेनिंग फैट्स एंड प्रोटीन्स, देयर अपटेक इज बीइंग गवर्न्ड बाय विटामिन बी सिक्स प्रेजेंस. सो विटामिन बी सिक्स हेल्प्स इन एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ fats and proteins. It also prevents nervous and skin disorders. So it prevents nervous disorders as well as the dermatitis or skin disorders. Hence it is used in treatment for epilepsy and dermatitis. It is used in the treatment of epilepsy as well as dermatitis, and its by coenzyme form for vitamin B6, that is phosphate group phosphate of form of vitamin B6 is utilized for many different types of reactions. The coenzyme form for vitamin B6 is pyridoxal phosphate and pyridoxamine phosphate. Pyridoxal phosphate and pyridoxamine phosphate, both of these are having similar structure. Here CH2O, this will be attached to a phosphate group. CH2OH will be attached to a phosphate group, and here it will be either a CHO or CH2NH2 depending on whether it is a pyridoxal or pyridoxamine. And this side we will have a OH and here a methyl group. This OH helps in the catalyzing the reactions for decarboxylation as well as transamination. ये दोनों रिएक्शंस में जो ट्रांजिशन स्टेट बनता है या इंटरमीडिएट जो बनता है, उस इंटरमीडिएट को स्टेबिलाइज करने के लिए ये ओएच ग्रुप जरूरी होता है यहाँ पर. व्हाइल दिस CH2OH विल बी यूटिलाइज्ड फॉर फॉस्फोरिलेशन एंड दिस बिकम्स अ पिरिडॉक्सल फॉस्फेट, दैट इज PLP, और इफ इट इज अ पिरिडॉक्सामाइन देन पिरिडॉक्सामाइन फॉस्फेट PMP. सो आइदर अ PLP और अ PMP विल बी will be formed, and this can catalyze many different types of reactions. So PLP or PMP takes part in say following reactions. Number one is transamination reaction. In transamination reaction, what happens is one of the keto acid is getting converted into an amino acid, and the amino acid gets converted into a keto acid. Like for example, this is pyruvic acid. This is aspartic acid. So this is an amino acid, and this is a alpha keto acid. we have an acidic group, and acidic group's alpha position is a keto group. So it is an alpha keto acid, and this is an alpha amino acid. So we can have this as an alpha amino acid, and this as an alpha keto acid. There will be an interconversion between these two. Either the keto group will be coming over here, and amine group will be going on the other group. So that our product will become, in presence of PLP or PMP, we will have this CH3, CH, NH2, COOH plus ये रिएक्शंस हमारी बॉडी में होते ही रहते हैं, बिकॉज जब भी हम कोई फूड कंज्यूम करते हैं तो उसमें जो प्रोटीन्स होते हैं, दोस प्रोटीन्स आर गेटिंग रप्चर्ड इन और हाइड्रोलाइज्ड इनटू अमीनो एसिड्स। इसमें हमारे जो जरूरी अमीनो एसिड्स होते हैं वो तो मिलते ही है, प्लस देर आर अदर अमीनो एसिड्स इन ए लार्जर क्वान्टिटीज विच आर नॉट रिक्वायर्ड इन दैट क्वान्टिटी। सो उसमें क्या करते हैं फिर, उनमें से जो अमीन ग्रुप होता है वो हमें कार्बोहाइड्रेट के इंटरमीडिएट्स में यूज करते हैं, और वहां से हम नॉन एसेंशियल अमीनो एसिड्स बनाते हैं। सो हमारा बॉडी ये नॉन एसेंशियल अमीनो एसिड्स इस प्रकार से यहाँ पे बनाते जाता है। सो नाउ दिस हैज बिकम एलेनिन इज वन ऑफ द अल्फा अमीनो एसिड्स, एंड दिस इज ऑक्सलो एसिटिक एसिड, ऑक्सलो एसिटिक एसिड। अगर ये हमारा COOH ग्रुप होता तो COOH इज एन ऑक्सलिक एसिड, और ये CH3COOH तो एसिटिक एसिड, सो दिस टू आर कंबाइनिंग टुगेदर, सो इट इज ए ऑक्सलो एसिटिक एसिड विल बी फॉर्म। सो फ्रॉम एस्पार्टिक एसिड अपॉन डीअमिनेशन वी गेट एन ऑक्सलो एसिटिक एसिड, एंड पायरुविक एसिड अपॉन अमिनेशन वी गेट ए एलेनिन। सो इट इज जस्ट एन इंटर कन्वर्जन ऑफ अल्फा कीटो एसिड एंड अल्फा अमीनो एसिड। दिस हैज बिकम नाउ अल्फा अमीनो एसिड, and this has become an alpha keto acid. So ye reactions ko catalyze karta hai PLP and PMP. These two that is pyridoxal phosphate and pyridoxamine phosphate, ye dono in reactions ko catalyze karte hain. We are just writing it. This our PLP, where CH2OH is converted as a phosphorylated to a phosphate group, or OH or CH3 हमने इस तरफ निकाला है, and CHO यहाँ पे. If we are reacting it with say an amino acid RCHNH2COOH, ये एक general amino acid है. तो यहां से ये H2 और यहां से O आउट होंगे, तो देर विल बी अ लॉस ऑफ वाटर मॉलिक्यूल एंड देर विल बी अ कंडेंसेशन प्रोडक्ट वी विल गेट। ओपी हियर वी विल हैव एन OH, हियर CH3, और यहां पर देर विल बी अ डबल बॉन्डेड N, दिस H, N के साथ में यहां पे CH COOH, and this side we have a R group. Now this lone pair of electrons on nitrogen is making a hydrogen bond with this hydrogen. Hydroxyl का जो hydrogen है वो इसे hydrogen bond बनाता है, so that we get a six-membered ring over here. So this stabilizes the adduct that has been formed. Now what happens is there will be a loss of proton, so that there will be relay of electrons in this way. We will have an NH, yahan pe double bonds, OP, here we have a double bond, hydrogen over here, nitrogen bonded with hydrogen, double bond carbon R COH. Now if we do hydrolysis mein kya hoga, there will be OH coming over here and H will be going on the nitrogen, or we can have it as H2 will be coming on nitrogen and O will be going on the hydrogen part, carbon part, so that this bond will now break and O will go there and H2 will be coming on the nitrogen side. This happens via the lone pair of electrons on this nitrogen. Yahan par aayega, this will go here, this will be coming over here, and this will be attacking the oxygen. Double bonded nitrogen, then we have H. Here we have OH, CH3, O. And what we have got here is, this we will get it as R. Here we'll have a double bonded O and COOH. So keto acid, we got it from amino acid. We got a keto acid. We have started with an amino acid, and now we have got a keto acid. Aur yahan par hamara kya hoga? This will now get reduced again. We will have a CH2, NH2 after accepting protons, and here OH, CH3, and phosphate. So what we have got is PLP se humne start kiya tha, pyridoxal phosphate aldehyde group. Now we have got an amine group over here. So this is our pyridoxamine phosphate. Pyridoxamine phosphate, we have got it. We had started with pyridoxal phosphate. So aldehyde se humne start kiya tha and we got a amine. Aur jo aldehyde group tha, oxygen that we have donated here, aur iska jo amine group hai wo humne yahan pe liya in vitamin B6. In the next step what happens is jo keto acid aayega dusra koi, उसको ये अमीन ग्रुप वहां पे प्रोवाइड कर देंगे, एंड एज सच ये अमीन ग्रुप वहां प्रोवाइड होगा तो यहां पर वापस से एल्डिहाइड ग्रुप बन जाता है. टू गेट वी गेट बैक द एल्डिहाइड ग्रुप हियर बैक अगेन. सो दिस इज हाउ दिस पर्टिकुलर ट्रांसअमिनेशन रिएक्शन वर्क्स. दिस इज वन रिएक्शन. द सेकेंड रिएक्शन दैट इट कैटेलाइजेस इज डी कार्बोक्सिलेशन रिएक्शन. In decarboxylation reaction, amino acids generally undergoes this decarboxylation. जो कार्बोहाइड्रेट का decarboxylation था वो विटामिन B1 कैटेलाइज करता है. अमीनो एसिड्स का decarboxylation विटामिन B6 कैटेलाइज करता है. तो यहां पर फॉर एग्जाम्पल histidine का decarboxylation here it will be this CH2 CH COOH and here NH2. This is a structure for histidine where it has an imidazole ring. So this in presence of PLP it will accomplish the decarboxylation of this amino acid to form CH2 NH2. There will be a loss of carbon dioxide and this becomes a histamine. Histamines are very important compounds in our body because this attaches with DNA and thereby it forms a recognizing point when there is a duplication of DNA. In transcription process, this the histamines forms the recognizing point for the enzymes that are duplicating the DNA molecules. That is DNA phosphorylase जो enzymes होते हैं उनको कहाँ से start करना है ये starting point के लिए ये histamines काफी जरूरी होते हैं. Similarly, when there is a correction is happening in DNA, वहाँ पर भी ये histamines forms a recognizing points for that. There are other also examples like tyrosine is another amino acid, aromatic amino acid. ये हमने देखा था last semester में for biosynthesis of tyrosine in shikimic acid pathway. This upon hydroxylation forms dihydroxy phenyl alanine or DOPA. This upon loss of carbon dioxide, which is catalyzed by again vitamin B6, that is pyridoxal phosphate, forms dopamine. This dopamine is further transformed into alkaloids, that is norepinephrine and epinephrines. So norepinephrine and epinephrine, these two can be synthesized from tyrosine or DOPA, that is dihydroxy phenylalanine, after decarboxylation steps only. So this is how this particular reactions are being carried out or being catalyzed by vitamin B6. Similarly, apart from this, it also catalyzes many different types of other reactions, like for example, it is required in synthesis of delta amino levulinic acid, delta amino levulinic acid, which is an intermediate for synthesis of heme molecule. For synthesis of heme, we require delta amino levulinic acid, and this is synthesized from glycine and salicylic and succinic acid. Glycine and succinic acid together combine in presence of PLP to form delta amino levulinic acid, which is further transformed into a heme molecule. So in synthesis of heme, we require this pyridoxal phosphate. Similarly, a tryptophan metabolism or synthesis of vitamin B3 is carried out from tryptophan by tryptophan conversion to 3-hydroxy pinurinine, 3-hydroxy pinurinine, which is converted in presence of PLP to 3-hydroxy anthranilic acid, which further converts into vitamin B3 or niacin, that is NAD plus and NADP plus. अगर ये नहीं होता है विटामिन B6 या PLP का एब्सेंस होता है या डेफिशिएंसी होता है, then this 3-hydroxy pinurinine is getting converted into xanthuronic acid. So in deficiency of vitamin B6, this tryptophan metabolism is hampered. And PLP plays an important role in metabolism of sulfur containing amino acids like homocysteine, gets converted to cystathionine in presence of PLP, which then converts to cysteine. So cysteine formation from homocysteine is also a PLP dependent reaction. Similarly, hydroxy containing amino acids like serine gets converted to pyruvic acid plus ammonia in presence of PLP. If PLP is not there, this reaction doesn't happen. So PLP is necessary in reactions of hydroxyl amino acids, that is amino acids containing hydroxy groups.
The deficiency diseases of vitamin B6. The first deficiency disease of vitamin B6 is it causes nervousness, insomnia, irritability. If there is a deficiency of vitamin B6, then it results into stomatitis and a general weakness. Majorly, B6 is involved in metabolism of tryptophan, so tryptophan as well as hemoglobin. So deficiency of vitamin B6 causes depression, mental confusion, and also it results in decreased hemoglobin. Because the synthesis of hemoglobin is altered, and also there will be an altered tryptophan metabolism. Instead of synthesis of vitamin B3, there will be xanthuria will be obtained, and the situation we call it as a hyperoxaluria. And formation of kidney stone will take place if there is a deficiency of vitamin B6. So generally it causes nervousness, insomnia, irritability, general weakness. There will be decreased hemoglobin content, altered tryptophan metabolism, and formation of kidney stone or hyperoxaluria will be the major causes for vitamin B6 deficiency. Hyperoxaluria is a excessive urine excretion of oxalates, that is calcium oxalate and sodium oxalates will be excreted out through urine through the kidneys. Individuals with hyperoxaluria often have calcium oxalate kidney stones. It is sometimes also called as Bird's disease, because this was discovered by Golding Bird. It has nothing to do with birds, but the person who discovered this particular situation, his name was Golding Bird, and so it has been named after his name as Bird's disease. पक्षियों से इसका कुछ लेना देना नहीं होता है. यहाँ पे सिर्फ इसका जो डिस्कवरर है उसका नाम बर्ड था, इसलिए बर्ड डिसीज या हाइपर ऑक्सैलुरिया. इसमें कैल्शियम ऑक्सैलेट जनरली ज्यादा प्रमाण में एक्सक्रीट होता है किडनीज के थ्रू, एंड देयर इज आल्सो फॉर्मेशन ऑफ किडनी स्टोन्स ऑफ कैल्शियम ऑक्सैलेट.